Hello, how are you? Can you notice my accent? Can you guess where I'm from? You can pause this video right now and go to the comments, leave a comment there and just guess where I'm from, judging from my accent, of course. Okay? Did it? Right, I'm from Russia and I don't actually speak like that. Although many people think that Russians have this strong and very pronounced accent, I haven't really had this problem, like, ever, I guess. When I studied in Switzerland and lived in Europe, people had a hard time guessing where I was from, and for some reason, they always thought I was from Germany. You see, I didn't even learn English abroad, and I guess that is a huge misconception that a person has to go and live in an English-speaking country to get rid of an accent. While in the reality, I know that maybe my current accent is not the cleanest in the world, and maybe I don't speak like a true native person. However, I still managed to reduce the harsh accent of mine without even leaving Russia once. Actually, when I went to Switzerland for my master's, it was the first time I had ever left the country. So let's dig deeper into this very interesting but daunting topic: how to reduce and get rid of the pronounced and strong accent and start speaking closer to like natives do. In the reality, the study of sounds, phonetics as they call it, is legit science that is quite complicated. So you can try to go the long way and get your head around all of these crazy hieroglyphs, or just follow the five steps that I take to get myself from this to this. Right, so at first you must decide what kind of an English accent you like and what kind of an English accent you want to acquire. So there are lots of different ones, not only the famous British and American ones, but also accents from New Zealand, Canada, Australia, and many other English-speaking countries. And in the UK alone, there are dozens of different accents. I personally go for the British one because I was taught so in school, and actually I genuinely like it right now. So let's get to the steps. The first step that I took is I chose a YouTube blogger or a bunch of YouTube bloggers that I liked watching, and I tried to pause from time to time their videos and just mimic words that they say. When I say mimicking, I mean not only repeating sounds after them, but rather trying to reflect their gestures, intonation, the pitch of their voice, and the stress that they put in their words, in sentences. So again, mimicking is not only saying the words after a native speaker, but also trying to get all of that feel and all of that behavior and maybe even the sound of the voice that those people have. Because, you know, the scientists show that learning languages and knowing languages even leads us to having multiple personalities, and that our brain treats different languages like different personalities inside ourselves. So it's a very interesting study and it's a very interesting domain of knowledge and science altogether. So again, mimicking means repeating actions, gestures, mimics, facial expressions, and of course, intonation, pitch of their voice. So let me give you an example. When I read books at my school where it was like, you know, hello, how are you? And I'm fine, you know, those simple dialogues that you get at school when you learn English, we would read them like that, like normally, you know, as reading a book. But this doesn't make us sound like natives, right? And when I started watching YouTubers and when I started mimicking them, I just genuinely tried to say that as they did it with all the intonation. So for example, they would go, oh, hello, how are you? Are you good? Great. And then the person would answer, oh yeah, I'm fine, thank you. Thanks for asking. And all of those facial expressions and intonations really mean a lot. It's not just reading, words and pronouncing sounds, but also trying to feel yourself a native person. The step number two is minding your rhythm. Rhythm is all about timing within a phrase or a sentence. This mainly equates to where we place the strong or weak stress in a sentence. For example, in a sentence like, "This is the worst thing you could have done ever," we emphasize two words here. We emphasize the word "worst" and then after a pause, the word "ever," right? Listen to it again. "That is the worst thing you could have done ever," right? So make sure you pronounce these sentences and phrases with correct rhythm, not just with zero intonation or zero timing. The next step that I always take and try to keep in mind is speaking slowly. When practicing your accent, it's not really the time to try and speak at the normal pace that native speakers have. Because when practicing, what you really must direct your attention to is to pronouncing every single sound very clearly without any harsh or dirty sounds that just shouldn't be there. So speak slowly, enunciate every single word that you say. Try to listen to yourself. How do you actually pronounce those words? Is it close to what native speakers do or not? And make pauses between your sentences and maybe between every single word so that you just pay more attention to your speech. My favorite technique after mimicking YouTubers is reading out loud. I really like this technique because it actually makes me think, what kind of an intonation should I use when reading? It's not just repeating after a person, it's actually trying to think and produce your own intonations, your own facial expressions, and your own rhythm, timing in a sentence. So do it when you are already more or less confident in your accent and know how natives speak. And the last step is recording yourself while reading or just when speaking plainly. Because I always play back my recordings and I always try to note where exactly I made a mistake and what words should I work on additionally. I also like recording myself in front of a mirror so that I see what facial expressions I have, what hand gestures I have, and how even do I open my mouth, because, you know, some natives do it differently, and this really can be noticeable when a native talks to a foreigner. I know that is crazy, but sometimes people commented on that as well. So these were the five simple steps that I have taken to reduce my accent, and for your convenience, I have put them together into one small and concise guide that you can download obviously for free. And I have also included in the guide three more steps with explanations, all the links and examples that you can use to improve your accent. To get this guide, make sure to follow me on my Instagram and send me a direct message with the word accent so that I can send you back the link to the guide. Thank you so much for tuning in and taking the time to watch this video. Comment down below what is your experience with the accent and if I'm able to help you with it. I will be very happy if you decide to leave a like for me or even subscribe. And as always, I will be delighted to see you again here. Ciao!